Just as promised by the international bodies, that everything will be done to make sure that Ahmadu Ike is set free and free at last. You see, first wagon has arrived the zoo soil. I don't care how you want to do it. I don't care what you want to say. You see this word? This word is growing evil on a daily basis. On a daily basis, this world we are living is growing evil. We all need to fix this in our heads. We seriously need to fix this in our heads. This world will keep growing evil on a daily basis. There's no two ways about it. The fight to restore Biafra remains our biggest priority. And nothing can stop us from how far we've gone and the way we have been running our things and making sure that everything is put in place. You know, they actually thought that holding Nnamdi Kanu is one of the best ideas. Not knowing that them holding Nnamdi Kanu is them exposing themselves more and more to disaster, whatever have you. And the first wagon just arrived, just as promised. For those who think that we are in to play, or we are in for jokes or bala blue, everything is now playing the way we want it to play. Everything is now playing the way we want it to play. And those who doubted us must feel that peculiar knowledge with which we shared in a long while. Our right for freedom mustn't be taken for granted. Because whether you like it or not, Biafra will remain one of the biggest energy we have around, no matter how they want to twist it. One of the biggest energy we have around. So let bygone be bygone, but hopefully they must release our leader to us. And that's more important. Very important, because our leader cannot be indulged on, and yet people of calibans who feel that they are God over men will be playing with our leader's life and his destiny. It's no longer possible. It's either Biafra or Biafra, and every day by day as time goes on, Obi na comments. Obi fane sike. You can keep Nnamdi Kanu how long they want to keep Nnamdi Kanu. But let them know that we have more Nnamdi Kanus waiting to rise. Finish it up, can finish it up, but guys, this guy has not committed any crime against anybody. Any damn person. So let's be guided. Our push to restore Biafra is becoming positive. And the order is shoe on side. It's either you get him out or you get them down. That is it. We cannot watch our brothers being killed for no reason. Every day you keep killing our brothers because of they refuse to believe in Nigeria, the scam that all these governments have put together to enforce it on those who have, with all honesty, refused to accept that scam. It's only in Nigeria they will tell you to do something, and when you refuse to do it, the next thing they begin to threaten your life. But let's put this mathematics together. How are we sure that if we can eventually believe in the so-called Nigeria they call themselves, how are we sure that things will go fine for Biafrans? We must be very careful. We've had enough, we've seen enough, and we're not ready to keep seeing more. Biafra will come, and I love the way everybody is working hand in hand to make sure that this nation called Biafra is free and freed at last. It must be put in place in a way it should be. But we cannot allow ourselves to be used. So I love what the UK Parliament is doing. Of course, they should respond because Nnamdi Kanu is their citizen. Amadike is their citizen. Nnamdi Kanu is not just a man anyone can just wake up and begin to toy with and begin to mess with. No, no, no. He's bigger than that. And that is why we are telling them, this is what you must do for our brother to be free. They know that if they let this man go, they are fully aware that what will happen will be more than what happened before. Dear friends, cannot be taken for granted. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Believe you me, when I say enough is enough, I know what I'm saying, enough is enough. Stop killing our brothers. And you, Igbos and Biafrans, stop killing yourselves. Because when you could was again, Nandume, Ndo Kasasia, Ndo Focasia, when you can get you there. And well, it is left for those who have felt the energy of rejection to tell you how rejection looks like. Don't just come out with another fallacy and you're telling that you're being marginalized. The only boys are being marginalized. Stop saying that! Because the level we are now, we have passed that mess that you people call lies of a zoo. Well, we are watching the whole drama. Let it begin.